In last period, good morning everybody. In last period, we define force. Force is a physical quantity which changes or tends to change the state of rest or the state of uniform motion. There are two types of the forces. One is balanced forces and the second is the unbalanced forces. Balanced forces defined as when two or more forces acting on the object simultaneously do not change the state of rest or the state of uniform motion are called the balanced forces, and unbalanced forces are defined as when two or the more forces acting on the object change the state of the rest or the state of uniform motion are called the unbalanced forces. Means to change the state of the rest or the state of uniform motion, which forces are necessary, the unbalanced forces are necessary to change the state of rest or the state of uniform motion. If you want to set the object in motion, then which force is necessary? Balance force is necessary or unbalanced force is necessary? So the unbalanced force is necessary to change the state of the rest or the state of uniform motion of the object. The in last period we see the when frictional force is balanced by the weight, we remain stationary on the surface of the earth. And there is one example in book, if there is a certain object and if you push it and if force is less than the frictional force, then it is not set into motion. But if the pushing force is greater than the frictional force, then the object is set into the motion. And when two forces are balanced, then object remains stationary. Today we see the laws of the motion. What are then the laws of motion? So there are three laws of motion, and they are Newton's first law of motion, Newton's second law of the motion, and the Newton's third law of motion. There are three laws of motion. Laws given by the scientist Newton, but the experiment is performed by the scientist Galileo. According to the Galileo, there are two inclined planes are taken. The what is mean by inclined plane? So this is then the horizontal plane, and a plane surface kept inclined to the horizontal, this is called the inclined plane. One, suppose AB is the one inclined plane and BC it is then the second. AB is one inclined plane and Suppose BC is the second inclined plane. The consider what is Galileo experiment. Consider the two inclined plane. What is mean by inclined plane then? A plane surface kept inclined to the horizontal surface is called the inclined plane. So this is then the horizontal surface or horizontal plane, and this is the plane kept inclined to the horizontal. So they consider the two inclined plane AB and the BC. When a piece of the marble, this is then the, these are smooth inclined plane, and the smooth inclined plane means there is no force of friction or there is frictionless plane, these are called the smooth inclined plane. The plane here, the smooth inclined plane means the frictional force is zero, or these planes are called the frictionless plane. The consider the smooth inclined plane AB and the BC, and a piece of the marble is left on the top of the inclined plane AB. म्हणजे दी पीस ऑफ दी मार्बल इज टेकन अँड धीस पीस ऑफ दी मार्बल इज रिलीज फ्रॉम दी टॉप ऑफ दी इन्क्लाइन प्लेन ए बी देन इट स्लो स्लाइड डाउन म्हणजे इट मूव इन दी डाउनवर्ड डायरेक्शन अँड climb up on the second inclined plane. Yeah, this is slide down on the first inclined plane, and then it climb on the another inclined plane. Now if, what is then the experiment? See, consider the two smooth inclined plane AB and BC. They are kept inclined to the horizontal plane. The piece of the marble is taken and it is released from the top of inclined plane. Then the piece of marble slide down. किंवा मूव इन दी डाउनवर्ड डायरेक्शन अँड देन इट क्लाइम ऑन दी अनादर इन्क्लाइन प्लेन ऑर इट मूव ऑनवर मूव अपवर्ड ऑन दी इन्क्लाइन प्लेन. इफ दी एंगल ऑफ इन्क्लिनेशन इज इक्वल मीन इफ धीस एंगल ऑफ इन्क्लिनेशन is equal to this angle of inclination, then then it climb to the same height as in the first inclined plane. If this is then the distance, then it climb at the same height on the another inclined plane. If angle of inclination is small, equal, then the height attained by the marble on the another inclined plane is same. Means height in the first case is equal to height in the second case. Now if the angle of inclination of the second inclined plane is decreased, म्हणजे this is then the angle of inclination, and if the angle of inclination is decreased of the second inclined plane, then the marble climb at the मोअर एट द मोअर हाईट, म्हणजे इफ धीस इज दी हाईट इन फर्स्ट प्लेस, धीस इज दी हाईट इन द सेकंड प्लेस, धीस इज देन द हाईट इन द थर्ड प्लेस. नाऊ व्हेन अँगल ऑफ इन्क्लिनेशन ऑफ द सेकंड प्लेन इज डिक्रीज्ड, देन द मार्बल क्लाइम ॲट द मोअर अँड द मोअर हाईट. अँड इफ अँगल ऑफ इन्क्लिनेशन ऑफ द सेकंड प्लेन इज मेड झिरो, मीन्स इट झिरो मीन्स देन इट अटे इट कंटिन्यू टू बी इन द मोशन, मीन्स इट रिचेस टू द सेम हाईट. बट इफ द प्लेन इज ॲट झिरो हाईट, सेकंड प्लेन इज ॲट झिरो हाईट, इट नेवर अटेन टू द हाईट, मीन्स द ऑब्जेक्ट आर द मार्बल कंटिन्यू to be in the state of motion, to be state in the motion, state of motion. The this is then the observation made by the Galileo. The if the angle of inclination is decreased, it reaches to more and the more height. And if angle of inclination is made equal to zero, then the object continue to be in the state of motion, or marble continue to be in the state of motion until it reaches to the height, and there is no height at all. Therefore, the object continues to be in the state of motion. The this experiment is performed by the Galileo. The what is the Galileo marble experiment? Consider the two smooth inclined plane AB and the BC. Inclined plane is defined as the plane surface kept inclined to the horizontal plane is called the inclined plane. Consider the two smooth inclined plane AB and the BC. The piece of the marble is released on the top of inclined plane AB, then it slides down and it then climbs to the second inclined plane. This is slide down, and then it climb up on the second inclined plane. So this is then the experimental setup. What is the experimental setup? Consider the smooth inclined plane AB and the BC. The inclined plane is the plane kept inclined to the horizontal plane. The piece of the marble is taken. The piece of marble is released on the top of inclined plane AB. Then it slides down and it climbs to the second inclined plane. Then if the angle of inclination of the first plane and angle of inclination of second plane is small, and that is then the equal, means angle of inclination of the first plane is equal to angle of inclination of the second plane, then the object climbs, then the marble climbs at the same height as in the first case, and means the height of the object in the first plane is equal to height of object in the second plane, provided that the angle of inclination is same. So what is then the first observation? कि व्हेन द मार्बल इज रिलीज फ्रॉम द टॉप ऑफ इंक्लाइन प्लेन ए बी एंड देन इट क्लाइम ऑन द सेकंड इंक्लाइन प्लेन म्हणजे इट स्लाइड डाउन एंड क्लाइम ऑन द सेकंड इंक्लाइन प्लेन इफ द एंगल ऑफ इंक्लिनेशन इज इक्वल देन द हाइट अटेन बाय द मार्बल ऑन द सेकंड प्लेन इज सेम as in the first case. Now, if the angle of inclination is decreased and the marble is released, then the marble attains more and more height if the angle of inclination is gradually decreased. Means, if angle of inclination is decreased, the marble climb to the more and the more height, and if angle of inclination is made equal to zero, then the marble continues in the state of motion till it reaches to the height, and there is no height of the plane in that side, and hence the marble continues to be in the state of the uniform motion. So these observations made by Galileo, these are then put by the scientist Newton in the form of laws, and the Newton's first law of motion states that every object continues to be in the state of rest or the state of uniform motion unless it is acted upon by some external unbalanced force. Means to change the continue to be in the state. Manje it there are two state of the object, one that is called the state of rest and the second is the state of uniform motion. Manje if the one of the object is at rest, it will remain in the rest position, or if the object continues to be in the state of uniform motion, it will continue to be in the state of uniform motion unless the unbalanced force is acting on the object. Means if object is at rest, then frictional force is balanced by the weight, and when unbalanced force is applied to the object, then object changes the state of rest and set into motion. Similarly, if the car is in uniform motion and if you apply the unbalanced force, means brakes are applied to the car, then the car comes to the rest position, means the uniform state of uniform motion is changed into the state of rest by unbalanced force acting on the object. So what is then this? From this Galileo experiment, the Newton's first law of Galileo performed the experiment, and from Galileo experiment, then the laws are put by the scientist Newton, known as Newton's laws of motion. And Newton's laws of first law of motion, there are three laws, and the first law of motion is every object continues to be in the state of rest or the state of uniform motion unless, kutparenta, it is acted upon by some external balance or unbalanced force. Because we have seen to change the state of rest or the state of uniform motion, unbalanced forces are required. So hence this is then the statement given by the scientist Newton and known as Newton's first law of motion. The statement of the Newton's first law of motion is every object continues to be in the state of rest or the state of uniform motion unless it is acted upon by some external unbalanced force. So this is then the Newton's first law of motion. What is the Newton's first law of motion? The Newton's first law of motion states that every object continues to be in the state of rest, to be in the state of rest or state of the uniform motion unless it is acted upon by some external unbalanced force, so this is then the Newton's uniform motion. The state of uniform motion along a straight line. In your course, there is only along a straight line. Manje, this is restricted only for straight line. This is then the Newton's first law of motion. Ki every object continues to be in the state of rest or the state of uniform motion along a straight line unless it is acted upon by some external unbalanced force. State the Newton's law of motion. If such type of question is asked, then Newton's first law of motion is every object continues to be in the state of rest or the state of uniform motion along a straight line unless it is acted upon by some external unbalanced force. So there are two conditions in this law. Every object continues to be in the state of rest, one part. Everybody continues to be in the state of uniform motion. Means if the object is at rest position, it will remain in the state of rest position. And if object is in the state of uniform motion, it will continue to be in the state of uniform motion. This is one part. And one condition is then given in this case, along a straight line. But how much? Unless it is acted upon by some external unbalanced force, means this state can be changed by applying the external unbalanced force. So do you understand the part of the law? Ki every object continue to be in the state of rest, one part. Everybody continues to be in the state of uniform motion, second part. But these conditions are then fulfilled, satisfied, unless it is acted upon by some external unbalanced force. That means if some external unbalanced force is not applied, then they remain in the state of rest or the state of uniform motion. But if external unbalanced force is applied to the object, then the object changes the state of rest or the state of uniform motion. So remember then, The statement should be written like this: every object continues to be in the state of rest or the state of uniform motion along a straight line unless it is acted upon by some external unbalanced force. There is meaning to every word in the law. Every object continues to be in the state of rest or the state of uniform motion along a straight line unless it is acted upon by some external unbalanced force. If the question is state Newton's first law of motion, then you write this. But sometimes there is question, state and explain the Newton's first law of motion. The statement is this: every object continues to be in the state of rest or the state of uniform motion unless it is acted upon by some external unbalanced force. This is statement. And explanation is, according to the Newton's first law of motion, when the object is in the state of rest, then it will continues to be in the state of rest unless it is acted upon by some external unbalanced force. Means, if there is car and if car is at the rest position, then the car will remain in the state of rest until the engine starts and unbalanced force is acting on the car. When unbalanced force is acting on the car by the engine, then car set into motion, means state of rest is changing into the state of uniform motion. Similarly, if the car is in moving, uniformly moving, then it continuously to be continues to be moving in the state of uniform motion unless the brakes are applied to the car, means unbalanced force is acting applied to the car and the car stop, means the state of uniform motion is changed into the state of rest position. The explanation is given like this. This is example of car. But you should write, when the object is in the state of rest, it will remain in the state of rest until the external unbalanced force is acting on it. This is one explanation. Second explanation is, when the object is in the state of uniform motion, it will continue to be in the state of uniform motion unless it is acted upon by some external unbalanced force. So this is explanation. Explanation is given in two parts. One, state of rest. Second, state of uniform motion. So what is explanation then? When the object is in the state of rest, it will remain in the state of rest until it is acted upon by some external unbalanced force. And second explanation is, when the object is in uniform motion, then it will continue to be in the state of uniform motion unless it is acted upon by some external unbalanced force. And we explain with the help of example. If question is like this, then take the example of car. When the car is at rest, it will remain in the state of rest until the engine starts, the unbalanced force is acting on the car. Now when unbalanced force is acting on the car by the engine, car is set into motion and state of rest is changing into the state of uniform motion. Then second, if the car is in the state of uniform motion, it will remain in the state of uniform motion until the brakes are applied to the car, means unbalanced forces acting on the car, and it brings to the rest position, means state of uniform motion is changed into the state of rest. So this is then the Newton's first law of motion. We sum up this. What is Newton's first law of motion? It is important. Every object continues to be in the state of rest or state of uniform motion along a straight line unless it is acted upon by some external unbalanced force. This is statement. And then explanation is, when the object is in the state of rest, it will remain in the state of rest until the external unbalanced force is acting on it. And when the object is in the state of uniform motion, it will continue to be in the state of uniform motion unless it is acted upon by some external unbalanced force. So this is then the Newton's first law of motion, and with the help of example, means we take the example of car. If car is at rest, it will continue to be in the state of rest until engine start, unbalanced force is acting on the car, then car set into the motion. If engine is not start, then it will remain in the state of rest. Similarly, if the car is in the state of uniform motion, it will continue to be in the state of uniform motion until the brakes are applied to the car. When brakes are applied to the car, unbalanced force is acting on the car, and the car brings to the rest position, means state of uniform motion is changed into the state of rest. From this example, we see that the state of rest or the state of uniform motion is changed due to only unbalanced force. So this is Newton's first law of motion. Every object continues to be in the state of rest or the state of uniform motion along a straight line unless it is acted upon by some external unbalanced force. Thank you.
Sir.